Hey, the ambulance guy was naked, right? I mean, technically he was naked. I think his underwear fell down.
I think he tried to wear boxers at some point.
All right, for the 17th straight show, it is time for a naked story. Here we go.
Whoa! It happened again! Someone decided to get naked!
It's time for another naked story on the 96.1 Kiss Morning Freak Show with Mikey and Big Bab.
I don't know if you guys saw this over the weekend, but somebody took a joyride with an ambulance in Philadelphia.
Witnesses describe a chaotic joyride through Northeast Philly in a stolen ambulance.
Seeing 20 cop cars, 5 helicopters going around, I was just shocked.
20 cop cars and 5 helicopters.
It's a lot.
It's an aggressive amount of police presence. Right.
After a confrontation with cops, a man in his underwear hops in an ambulance. The driver plows into parked patrol cars and stops.
Now listen, nobody got hurt here. It was just a guy who was out of his mind in his underwear for some reason.
He had quite the run in the ambulance.
Who decided to steal an ambulance.
Officers cautiously approach the ambulance, some with guns drawn. A police officer opens the door, but the man floors it.
Yep.
He starts a wild ride after police shot him 3 times.
Yeah, the video is crazy because this guy is just in an ambulance, like going through intersections and everything. It's like one of the wild car chases you see out like in L.A. or on the West Coast or something.
Our eye in the sky tracks the ambulance through residential streets with lights flashing.
By the way, he's in his underwear the whole time,
Moments later, the man T-bones an innocent driver.
Yeah.
After more than an hour on the road, the chase ends when police use spike strips to flatten the ambulance tires. Police rush the vehicle. 2 officers struggle to pull the driver out by his legs.
Also, the driver's underwear struggled to stay on.
That's the point.
As they pull them out, because if you see the video, they go from not blurring the box when he like is in the ambulance and the door is open to then when they pull him out, it's just like, oh, we got to blur it now.
Officers control the crowd as they take the thief into custody.
Again, nobody was seriously injured in this.
His underwear barely hanging on, and he had a taser line dragging behind him.
His underwear was like somebody holding onto the edge of the cliff by like 2 fingers. Like eventually, you're going to have to let go. And his underwear did.
A closer look shows a bearded man in his 40s.
Yeah.
Eyes glossed over. The end of a night that some will never forget.
Yeah.
In total, the driver hit 2 cop cars, a tow truck, some other cars, and indirectly caused another crash too.
This could have been a lot worse. A lot of people, it could have been a lot more accidents, a lot more collisions, I should say. And the injuries could have been a lot more severe.
Now, you never really know who is going to go on a rampage like this and steal an ambulance and lead the police through this wild chase, but then you open the door and it's a bearded 40-year-old man with just his underwear on and it's just barely hanging on at all.
Barely.
And when they pull him out, they have to blur the box and everything. I wonder if the news was like, oh, we got to get this video of the ambulance driver getting pulled out for the 11 o'clock news.
Back
and then
out.
All of a sudden they're just like, oh man, John in the graphics department, you got to blur this. We can't air this right now.
Like he is so naked.
You got to blur. Can you, like, sometimes I think about the discussions that happen at TV stations, like, we got the video ready to go. They're going to pull the guy out of the ambulance. We got to see who it is. We got to get that ready for
the 10
o'clock news. And they pull it out and just like, can't air it. John's got to blur the box. It's a naked person making the show once again.